This video shows how to run the Quantum Leaps QUTest unit tests on embedded Linux targets. QUTest is a unit testing harness specifically designed for embedded systems. It relies on the QPSPY software tracing, which was introduced in the previous video about running QP and QPSPY on embedded Linux. So, picking up where the previous video left off, I will be using again Raspberry Pi as my embedded Linux target. I log into the Pi using PuTTY. And change to the QP/QPCPP directory, which has been created in the previous video. This time, I go to the examples QTest directory that contains various tests. And finally, I choose the Dining Philosophers problem DPP subdirectory. This example is essentially identical to the DPP application in the examples POSIX directory discussed in the previous video. Except that this version contains also a test fixture, test scripts, and makefiles to run the tests on various embedded targets, as well as on the host. Among others, the DPP directory contains the POSIX.make makefile for POSIX targets. As usual in test-driven development, TDD, this makefile both builds and runs the tests. So before executing make, I need to launch QSPY on the host to communicate with my Raspberry Pi target. I open a command prompt on my Windows host and launch QSPY identically as in the previous video. I use two command line options. Minus U, meaning that I want to open a UDP port for testing, and minus T, meaning that I want to start a TCP/IP server socket, waiting for target connections. Now I can run the POSIX.make makefile, whereas I provide the host IP address as the argument host equals the IP address of my Windows host. Of course, you need to adjust this address to your network. The very first build of the test takes a bit longer because the QP framework is compiled directly from sources. All subsequent builds will be much faster, as typically only the changed files from the CUT, code under test, need to be recompiled. After the build completes, you can see that the make immediately starts to run the test fixture, and is running it in a while loop. This is because the test fixture will be restarted several times by the test scripts running on the host to perform a clean reset of your embedded Linux application before each test. Also, please note that the QSPY host application reports that the target has connected. At this point, you are ready to run your QTest test scripts. As usual, you run them from the host machine. So on the host, you open a second command prompt and change directory to qpcpp examples qtest dpp, which is the same directory as on the Linux target. To run the test scripts on the host, you use the same posix.make makefile as you used on the POSIX target, even though this is a Windows machine. The only difference is that on the host you provide the test build target, which means that you only wish to run the tests, but without building the test fixture, because this was already done on the Linux target. The QTest tests execute on the host by sending commands to the target via the QSPY utility. This communication between the QTest scripts and QSPY happens over the UDP connection opened by the -u option in QSPY. QSPY then forwards the commands from the test scripts to the connected target over TCP/IP in this case. The test fixture on the target responds by executing the CUT and generating the software trace from the run. This output is sent back to QSPY, which displays the information in human-readable format and also forwards the data to the test script to verify the expectations of the test. A test is considered successful only when all the test expectations are met exactly, and otherwise the test fails. For example, here is a typical QTest test script with multiple expectations. Also, most QTest tests begin with resetting the embedded target to guarantee clean start of a test. Every such reset request causes the test fixture on the target to exit, which is followed by restarting a fresh new instance of the test fixture. That's why the POSIX makefile restarts the test fixture from the while loop I mentioned earlier. And so, here you see one of the biggest advantages of QTest compared to the other unit test harnesses for embedded systems, like Unity or CPPU test. In contrast to such traditional solutions, which are all based on the original X unit, QTest separates the execution of the CUT from checking the test assertions. This means that a single test fixture can be used for many different tests. This dramatically shortens the TDD, test-driven development, microcycle in embedded systems, because you need to rebuild and upload the target resident part much less frequently. The tests are entirely managed on the host machine rather than the resource-limited target. Moreover, the test scripts don't require recompilation and are immediately ready after editing. Here, for example, I comment out an expectation in a test script and run it immediately again. As you can see, this time the modified test fails because of the mismatch between the expected and actually received output. Finally, you can shorten the TDD microcycle even further by moving the testing entirely from the embedded target to the host, so you run both the test fixture and the test scripts on your host machine. This strategy is called dual targeting, and the QTest harness has been specifically designed to fully support it. To show you how easy it is, I first disconnect the embedded Linux target from QSPI by pressing Ctrl-C on the Linux console. And next, I undo the change in the test script and simply type make on the host. As you can see, this builds the test fixture and runs the test scripts on the host. The resulting output is exactly the same as the test run from the Linux target. This dual targeting is possible because the board support package, BSP, is written only in terms of the QPSPI macros and therefore is completely portable across all targets, including deeply embedded boards with ARM Cortex-M microcontrollers. This concludes this short demonstration of QTest on embedded Linux. To find out more about QTest, you can visit statemachine.com and click on QTest Unit Testing Harness in the QTools section. Thanks for watching!